Hi, I'm Christopher Johnson, and in this video I'll be telling you about the Agile BioFoundry's work in metabolic pathway development and evaluation, and how it can be leveraged toward your own products of interest. The overall goal of the Agile BioFoundry is to develop synthetic biology infrastructure to reduce the time to market within the biomanufacturing industry. A useful analogy for how public infrastructure investment can enable private industry is nicely depicted in this image from a Lyft advertising campaign, showing how a subway system could allow travelers to get close to their destination, and then they could take a Lyft to go the last mile or so. In the Agile BioFoundry, the equivalent of a subway stop could be a key metabolic intermediate, which we refer to as a beachhead molecule. We envision that development of a strain for production of a bioproduct associated with a particular beachhead would enable rapid development of strains targeting related bioproducts. In this way, metabolic engineering strategies developed for a given target can be applied to other targets associated with the same beachhead, and similar theoretical yields and processing parameters would enable techno-economic analysis and life cycle assessment of a single exemplar product to extend to similar products associated with the same beachhead. To that end, the ABF is developing microbial strains for production of several exemplar products shown in blue circles on this metabolic map that are associated with beachheads shown in green. We're expanding the number of beachheads we're developing over time, and potential beachheads are shown in gray circles. Here we'll be focusing on one exemplar target, muconic acid, which can be catalytically hydrogenated to generate adipic acid. Adipic acid is considered one of the most important dicarboxylic acids because of its use in the production of plastics, including nylon 66, polyurethane, and polyethylene terephthalate. The beachhead associated with muconic acid is Protocatechuate, and the host for production is the soil bacterium Pseudomonas putida. To engineer Pseudomonas putida to produce muconic acid from glucose, a pathway originally demonstrated in E. coli by Karen Drass and John Frost was introduced to pull carbon from the shikimate pathway for aromatic amino acid biosynthesis to muconic acid through the Protocatechuate beachhead. To improve yields, a DHP synthase that's resistant to feedback inhibition from aromatic amino acids was introduced, and metabolic modeling was leveraged to identify genetic targets that ultimately enabled a yield of 38% in strain CJ522. While this was a higher yield than the 30% that had been demonstrated in E. coli, the productivity needed to be improved. To address this, we performed adaptive laboratory evolution on CJ522, shown in red on these graphs, to improve growth, and then used a muconate biosensor to isolate evolved strains that also maintained a high yield of muconate. The strain GB271 ultimately achieved a productivity of 0.2 grams per liter per hour, which was 3 times higher than CJ522, while maintaining about the same yield. And development of these strains is ongoing. I'm going to switch gears now to tell you a little bit about the evaluation and analysis that's been done within the Agile BioFoundry around the production of adipic acid in a biorefinery. This diagram shows the parameters and process configuration for conversion of corn stover in a biorefinery, and this is the context for techno-economic and life cycle analysis that was performed to identify the key drivers of the minimum selling price and greenhouse gas emissions associated with biological production of adipic acid. In the figure on the left, the results of techno-economic analysis indicate that the minimum selling price of adipic acid can be reduced substantially by increasing the yield to about 50% and the productivity to about 0.15 grams per liter per hour, after which the benefits level off. This puts adipic acid produced by GB271, the best performing strain I showed you earlier, at about $3 a kilogram, and improving the yield or the productivity has the potential to bring that price closer to the reference market price for petroleum-derived adipic acid, which is about $1.89 per kilogram. On the right, life cycle analysis indicates that greenhouse gas emissions associated with bio-derived adipic acid are driven by productivity more than yield, and they're much lower than fossil-based adipic acid, which generates about 10 kilograms of CO2 equivalent per kilogram of adipic acid. Again, the goal of this work is to establish strain development strategies and analysis associated with particular products that can be leveraged as jumping-off points for development and analysis of related products. And this represents one way the Agile BioFoundry is developing infrastructure to enable the biomanufacturing industry. For general inquiries about the Agile BioFoundry, you can reach us at info@agilebiofoundry.org. And for questions associated with pathway development and evaluation, you can email John Gladden, Greg Beckham, or me directly.